स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल सॉल्व प्रैक्टिस 1.3 फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन. ओके, आई हैव नॉट रिटन क्वेश्चन ऑन द बोर्ड. आई विल रीड एंड देन आई विल एक्सप्लेन व्हाट टू डू. ओके, सो सी इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक्स ऑल्सो. क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 इज द पॉपुलेशन ऑफ अ मेट्रो सिटी वॉज 1,37,28,345 इन 2010. It increased by 15,24,215 in next 2 years, and also 12,50,360 persons migrated from the city either to other cities or to foreign country during this period. Find the population of the city in 2012. Okay, this is the question. Now we have seen what is given. Population in 2010 is 1,37,28,345. This is the total population of the city in 2010. Now in next 2 years, number of people increased. How many people increased? That they have given in 2 years. That is 15,24,215. And number of people migrated. Now, do you know the meaning of migrated? Migrated means they travel from one city to other city or other country. Means, see, a number of people migrated in other city or country. Means from the given city, they shifted to either in the country, others outside country or in other city. So how many people they shifted from the same city? 12,50,360 people they went from the city. What we have to find out? We have to find out total population in 2012. Okay, now see how to solve. First of all, what we'll have to do? See, total number of people in that city is 1,37,28,345. In this number, in next 2 years, how many people increased? Increased means what we have to do? We have to do addition. So 15,24,215. This number we have to add in the total population. So add means we have to plus, we have to do addition. 15,24,215. Okay, now addition you will have to do. So 5 plus 5 10, 0, we have to carry 1 to the next number. Now 1 plus 4 5 plus 1 6, 2 plus 3, 5, 4 plus 8, 12, carry 1, 2 plus 2, 4 plus 1, 5, 7 plus 5, 12, carry 1, 1 plus 3, 4 plus 1, 5 and 1, means after 2 years, how many people, number of people increased? 1,52,52,560. Okay. Now from this number, 12,50,360 people, they went in other country or city. They migrated. Means what we have to do? They went. Means we have to do subtraction. Okay. So therefore, 1,52,52,560, from this number we have to subtract 12,50,360. Okay, so do subtraction. 0 minus 0 0, 6 minus 6 0, 5 minus 3 2, 2 minus 0 2, 5 minus 5 0, 2 minus 2 0, 5 minus 1 4, and 1 as it is. That is 1,40,02,200. Okay. So, what will be the total population in 2012? Final answer. The total population in 2012 will be 1,40,02,200. Followed? Now, next question, question number 6. In the Lok Sabha election in a constituency, the successful candidate polled 18,25,355 votes and won the election by a margin of 1,37,415 votes. How many votes did his nearest rival polled? Okay, that we have to find out. First of all, you should understand the meaning of question. Now see here, two things are there. Number of votes polled to the successful candidates. How many votes successful candidate got? These many votes he got. Okay. And by how many votes he won that election? He won by 1,37,415 votes. So find the number of votes polled to the nearest rival. So how many votes his rival got? That votes we have to find out. So what to do? See here, the successful candidate got these many number of votes. So what we have to do, from the number of votes, if we'll subtract by how many votes the candidate won, then whatever answer we will get, that will be the number of votes polled to the nearest rival. So we have to subtract. See here, this is the total number of votes. Okay. From this, we have to subtract by what margin successful candidate won the election? By these many votes. See, so this number, 1,37,415, we will subtract from the total number of votes. My 5 minus 5, 0. 5 minus 1, 4. Now, can we subtract 4 from 3? No, because 4 is bigger than 3. So borrow 1 from the next digit. So from 5, we will borrow 1 here. Here 5 minus 1, 4 will remain. And this 3 we'll have to write up. So total it made 13. Now 13 minus 4, how much? 9. Okay. Now 4 minus 7, is it possible? No. Again, no. So again, borrow 1 from 2. Here 1 will remain. 2 minus 1, 1. Now 14 minus 7 is 7. Again, 1 minus 3 is not possible. So borrow 1 from 8. Here 7 will remain. 11 minus 3, 8. Okay. 7 minus 1, 6. And 1 as it is. So, by how many votes the other candidate, his nearest rival polled, he got the his nearest rival got 16,87,940 votes. So final answer we'll have to write. Number of votes polled to the nearest rival are 16,87,940. Understand? question number 7 is the number of sheets of paper available for making notebooks is 1,25,000. Each sheet makes 8 pages of a notebook. Each notebook contains 250 pages. How many notebooks can be made from the available sheets of paper? That we have to find out. Okay. See here, what are the given things? The given things are, number one, total number of sheets of paper. Okay. Total how many sheets are there? 1,25,000. Now, each sheets make 8 pages of a notebook. Each sheet means what? One sheet. In one sheet, 8 pages of a notebook we can make. So, and next what else is given? Each notebook contains 250 pages. In every one notebook contains 250 pages. So, to find number of notebooks made from available sheets means how many number of notebooks we can make from the available sheets, means from these sheets, how many notebooks we can make. Now for that, we will find out the solution. Okay. See here. Each sheets make 8 pages. Now total number of pages, sheets are 1,25,000. 1,25,000. Okay. And one sheet make 8 pages. So, from these many sheets, how many pages we can make? For that, we have to multiply the number of sheets by 8. Why 8? Because in one sheet, 8 pages we can make. So, in 1,25,000 sheets, how many pages we can make? For that, we have to multiply total number of sheets by 8. So we will multiply then. 8 zeros are 0. 8 zeros are 0. 8 zeros are 0. See, students, keep in mind, if we are going to multiply any number with 0, then always answer comes 0. Okay? 8 zeros are 0. 8 zeros are 0. 100 into 0 also answer will come 0 only. So, now 8 5s are 40. 40. So, 0 we will write here. Unit place digit and tens place digit will carry. Now, 8 2s are 16 plus 4, 20. So, that 0 again 2 will have to carry. Now, next 8 1s are 8 plus 2, 10. Okay. So, how many total number of pages can be made from this many sheets? 10 lakh pages. Okay. 10 lakh pages we can make by these many sheets. Now, each notebook contains 250 pages. So, how many notebooks we can make? Now, in one notebook, 250 pages are there. So, from these 10 lakh pages, how many notebooks we can make? For that, we have to divide 10 lakh by 250. Okay. Now, 250 and 250 fours are, see here, 25 fours are 100. So, 250 fours are, what number you will get? 4 zeros are 0. 4 5s are 20, carry 2, 4 2s are 10 plus 2, 4 2s are 8 plus 2, 10, 1000. Got it? So, 25, 4s are 1000. So, 0, 0, 0, 0. Over? Did we get the answer? No, because still this 0 we have to divide. So, take this 0 down, 250 zeros are 0. Okay? Then, take this 0 down. At a time, only one digit we can take. So, now this 0, then again 250 zeros are 0. Now, last 0, take here, again 250,000. So how many notebooks we can make from 10 lakh pages? 4,000 notebooks. Followed? Question number 8. By what value is the greatest number made from the digits 723521 larger than the least number made by using the same digit? Means what? We have to make the greatest number and smallest number, okay, by using this digit. And we have to find out by how many number the greatest number is larger than the smallest number. So first we will make the greatest number. Okay. Now see, look at the digits. Greatest digit, greatest number. How to make? By arranging the digits in descending order. Got it? Now here, which is the largest digit? 7. Then which will come? 5. Then 3. Then 2. Then again 2 is there and 1. Okay. Next, we have to make the smallest. Least number means smallest. So least number by using the same digits is 1, 2, 2, 3, 5, 7. Now we have to find out by how many numbers this greatest number is bigger than this smallest number. So for that, we have to subtract smallest number from the greatest one. So see here, 7, 5, 3, 2, 2, 1 minus 1, 2, 2, 3, 5, 7. Okay. Now, can we subtract 7 from 1? No. So again, as 1 is smaller than 7, we have to borrow 1 from the neighboring digit. So 2 minus 1, here 1 will remain, and here this 1 will have to write up plus this 1. Plus means this 10's plus 1, that is 11. Now 11 minus 7, 4. Okay. Now again 1 minus 5 is not possible. So again borrow 1 from the next neighboring digit. So here 1 will remain. 11 minus 5, 6. Again same. Again borrow 1 here. Here 2 will remain. 11 minus 3. 11 minus 3 is 8. So here 8. Now 5 minus now 2 minus 2 is 0. 5 minus 2, 3. And 7 minus 1, 6. Okay, so by how many numbers greatest number is bigger than the smallest number? The greatest number is bigger than 6,30,864 by the smallest number. See here, next question, question number 9. I will read out the question. A bookshop sold 8,538 books in the month of June. Its sale rose by 212 books in the next month. If profit on selling one book is rupees 25, find the total profit earned by bookshop in June and July. Okay. So, what is the meaning of the question? See here. Or what is given in the question? Number of books sold in the month of June. This many, 8,538. Sale rose by 212 books in next month. Means next month, after June, which month comes? July. So in July month, sale rose, means increased. How many more books they sold? 212 books. 12 more books they sold in the month of July. Next, profit on one book is rupees 25. Means on every book they earn 25 rupees profit. What we have to find out? We have to find out total profit earned in June and July. Okay, so first what we have to find out, first we will find out what profit they earned in the month of June. Now month of June, these many books they sold. So, and profit earned on one book is rupees 25. So this book, number of books multiplied by 25, that will be the profit earned in the month of June. So we will find out. See here. 8538, this number we will multiply by 25, because one book we earned, the shopkeeper earned 25 rupees. So this many books, see here, 5 is a 40. First we will multiply by 5, so 5 8 is a 40, 0 carry 4, 5 3 is a 15 plus 4, 19, carry 1, 5, 5 is a 25, plus 1, 26, carry 2, 5, 8 is a 40, plus 2, 42, okay. Now, we will multiply by 2, and 2 is at tens place, so unit place, we will have to write 0. Now, 2, 8 is a 16, carry 1, 2, 3 is a 6, plus 1, 7, 2 5s are 10, carry 1, 2 8s are 16 plus 1, 17, 0. Now add, 6 plus 9, 15, carry 1, 7 plus 6, 13, plus 1, 14, carry 1, 2 plus 1, 3, 7 plus 4, 11, carry 1, and 1 plus 1, 2. So, how many rupees? See, 2,13,415.50 rupees profit they earn in the month of June. Now in the month of July, see here, profit earned in June. Okay. Now sale, number of books sold in July is equal to, see, in June month this many, and the sale rose by 212, means 212 more books they sold. So how to find out that? So see here, 8538, in that we have to add 212. 8 plus 2, 10, carry 1. 1 plus 3, 4 plus 1, 5. 5 plus 2, 7, and is 8. So, how many number of books they sold in July? This many. Now, we have to find out profit earned in the month of July. For that, what we will have to do? For that, we will have to multiply 8750 by 25 again, because on one book they earn 25 rupees profit. So in July month, how much profit they will earn, that we have to find out. So that we will do by multiplying this by 25. 8750 multiply by 25. 5 into 0, 0. 5 5s are 25, carry 2, 5 7s are 35, plus 2, 37, now 7, carry 3, 5 8s are 40, plus 3, 43, okay, this we will cancel. Now we will have to multiply by 2, 2 is at tens place, so unit place 0, 2 zeros are 0, 2 5s are 10, carry 1, 2 7s are 14, plus 1, 15, carry 1. 2 8s are 16, plus 1, 17. This is the addition, okay? This many rupees profit earned in July. got it, these many rupees profit they earn in July. Now total, what will be the profit? What to do for that? To find out the total profit, we have to add profit earned in June month and profit earned in July month. So now we will earn, now we will add. So total profit is equal to this profit earned in June month plus profit earned in July month, and 0, 5 plus 5, 10, carry 1, 7 plus 4, 11, plus 1, 12, carry 1, 8 plus 3, 11, plus 1, 12, carry 1, 1 plus 1, 2 plus 1, 3, and 2 plus 2, 4, that is rupees 4,32,200. This is the total profit earned in the month of June and July. Follow? Next question number 10 is, here, a machine manufactures 5,253 pairs of nuts and bolts each day. After the completion of month of April, these pairs of nuts and bolts are distributed to 6 dealers. How many pairs of nuts and bolts does each dealer get? Also find, if any, the number of leftover pairs of nuts and bolts. Okay. Now see here, what is given? 5,253 pairs of nuts and bolts made in each day. Next, these nuts and bolts are distributed to 6 dealers. And what we have to find out? We have to find out number of pairs of nuts and bolts does each dealer get, and second, if any pairs of nuts and bolts left over. See, for this, first we have to find out in April month total how many number of pairs of nuts and bolts are made. For that, what we have to do? See here, in April month, how many days are there? 30 days. Okay, in April month 30 days are there. So how many nuts and bolts can be made in April month? See here, number of nuts and bolts made in the month of April, is equal to, how to find out? By multiplying this 5,253 by total number of days. In April month, how many days are there? 30 days are there. So 5,253, we will multiply it by 30. Okay, number of days in April month. 0, 3 is a 0, 0, 5 is a 0, 0, 2 is a 0, 0, 5 is a 0. Now we will multiply by 3. So first unit place compulsory 0. Now 3, 3 is a 9, 3, 5 is a 15, 5 carry 1, 3, 2 is a 6, plus 1, 7, 3, 5 is a 15. And add the number. Okay. So total, how many pairs of nuts and bolts are made? These many pairs of nuts and bolts are made in the month of April. Now, these pairs are distributed in 6 dealers. Okay. So how many pairs does each dealer will get? How to find out that? For that, you will have to divide the given number by 6, because 6 dealers are there. So then what we have to do? We will have to divide the number of pairs of nuts and bolts by the number of dealers. How many dealers are there? 6 dealers are there. Now see, we will divide. Is it possible to divide 1 by 6? No, because 1 is smaller than 6. So take 2-digit number, 15. Now in 6 table, which number is near to 6, 15 and which is smaller also? Okay. So 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 6 threes are 18. But 18 is greater than 15. So previous number is 6 twos are 12. So here 6 twos are 12. This number is close to 15 and it is smaller also. Now subtract 5 minus 2, 3. 1 minus 1, 0. Carry 7. Now in 6 table, 6, 6 is 36. Is near to 37. So 6, 6 is 36. 7 minus 6, 1. 3 minus 3, 0. Now take 5 down. Okay. Again see 15 is there. So 6 twos are 12. What will remain? 5 minus 2, 3, 0. And take 9 down. Again 6, 6 are 36. 9 minus 6, 3. Take this 0 down. And 6, 5 are 30. Okay. 6, 5 are 30. So, total how many number of nuts and bolts does each dealer will get? So, each dealer will get 26,265 pairs of nuts and bolts. Followed?